Well, welcome to everybody here. It was actually advertised as a landscape workshop because I am actually basically a landscape artist. Has anybody here not doing a landscape? One, two, you are, and you. So there's only about three of you. Why I'm asking that is because I'd like to talk a little bit about landscape, the whole point of it and so on. I run a landscape oil painting class in the week, and one of the things I always insist with the students, and some of the students are actually here in this room, was that if they work from reference, which is a photograph, I prefer it to be a drawing, but if it's a photograph, then it has to be a drawing or a photograph that you've actually taken yourself. Because you don't know the place if you haven't been there, it's somebody else's image, and all you're doing is sort of doing somebody else's image. It's terribly important that you get a sense of place when you're doing a landscape. It is about that. A painter that you all heard of, Constable, he said he doesn't paint landscapes, he paints feelings. Well, you can only get that feeling if you've been there and you know it. And that's one of the things which I'm really, really immersed in landscape, and particularly East Anglian landscape, because I know it so well. So it's really important. If you don't get that feeling, you won't get that sense of it. No matter how well you paint it, and some of you are probably very skillful, and there are people who are incredibly skillful, but if it doesn't say anything other than what it's, you know, from the photograph, or in fact even a very good drawing, it's not going to tell you anything about the landscape itself and how you feel about it. It's very much a two-way thing when you're a painter. It's about your connection with the subject, whether it's a portrait, a landscape, still life, or anything you like. You've got to have that connection. Otherwise, it's going to be a fairly dead painting, no matter how well it is that it's done. I thought I'd get that out of the way before we start. Now, I know a lot of you probably have brought stuff in which you've already started. And I'm going to come round and talk to you about your work as far as it's gone. I'm going to start over with Linda because she's just starting a painting, so we can see how she's actually going to start it, and I'll talk to her about that. That's really all I want to say to take your time up. There will be a tea break, you'll be pleased to hear. So I'm going to start now. I'm going to start walking off. Okay, Linda.
Hi.
How are you doing? All right?
Well, I've got some pictures here that I did at the Steam Museum.
Yeah.
Lots of drawings and photographs.
Yeah. I just have a look. Yeah.
I photographed that in black and white to help me with the.
So which one of these are you going to do?
It's this.
Is it
mainly
that one?
That one.
Okay.
Yes.
Good.
And I've got this so that I can see the colours.
Yeah. Well, that's, yeah, but and also that's a colour study, isn't it?
That's a painting, a finished painting.
Good, excellent.
Another part.
Right, so you're going to fit it all onto that shape,
do you
think?
Hopefully it's double. It's about double.
I see you've done your homework. Very good, excellent. Okay, Linda, so what are you going to do? Draw it out in pencil or just go straight in?
Well, I was going to do an acrylic base and then go into oils.
Good. Well done. Okay then, well, just start and I'll come and see you later. That's brilliant. Super.
Okay, thank you.
No, I know it's not landscape, but it doesn't really matter. You know, it's got all that sort of element of personal involvement. You know, you did the drawings and so on.
I was just really at home in this place.
Yeah. No. Where was it by?
Steam Museum in London. I can't remember exactly where, but it's called Steam Museum.
It might be Kew.
Yes, that's it. Kew. Right.
Well done. Okay, I'll see you later.
Thank you very much.
All right, Norma, how are we doing? Oh, sheep. Have you seen sheep? Sheep? That's new for you, isn't it?
Yes, I don't usually do. I've never done sheep before, but yeah. I do like doing animals.
Yeah.
And when I look at animals, I'm always fascinated by the shapes of them.
Right.
In fact, I look at them more than the landscape behind.
Yeah,
and here I'm making a real effort because it's a landscape workshop.
Yeah. Yeah.
To put in a landscape.
Right.
These are sheep that I know quite well. They're Welsh sheep. They've got names like Bronwyn and
You know
Megan.
Them all by name.
And I've even eaten a bit of one of them, I have to say.
Let's go there.
Because they belong to friends of mine.
So how long did you spend on putting that in?
So far, it was about an hour. I very quickly painted over a painting that was underneath.
Great.
And I always like to work anyway on a canvas with something going on.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to try and copy absolutely everything, but just pick out a few of them.
Right.
And maybe do something.
You're doing all these trees up there?
I'll do the trees, but again, I'm not necessarily trying to reproduce them exactly.
But because they're quite nice dark shapes.
Yes, I like the contrast in dark.
And also, your light's coming from there, so you're getting a shadow.
Yes, that's right. So it makes it more interesting because grass can be very, very boring if it's not.
Actually, what doesn't happen there but happens in yours is the ground does move away quite atmospherically, doesn't it? Which is quite nice. I think it's partly because you haven't got that in.
Yes, but I will.
Will you put that in?
Try and put some of that
some
in
of
anyway.
Well, keep that lightness because that's really rather good, especially with these seen against the light. These will be darker, won't they? Probably.
But I find myself having to resist the temptation to draw their eyelashes almost before I've done
the sheep
rest.
Have eyelashes? They probably do. Anyway, that's a really good start, Norma. That's terrific.
Well, I'm enjoying it so far. But
yeah, you look as though you are. You always look as though you are. But yeah, that's terrific.
Yeah.
Right, I'll come and see you later.
Okay, thanks, Roy.
Okay. Right, how are we doing? So is this what you're working from? Or?
Yeah.
Work.
It helps with my vision of how the silver birch look.
Yeah.
I'm actually going to make a semi-impressionistic.
So what, you're going to put these away now? Really?
I'm not using them.
No, that's good.
I'm going to continue with this look here, this tree. And as I paint each one, I'm going to brush across and give it that misty quality.
With this washy sort of
loose? And probably with a big sponge or something.
Oh, good.
I've got a big brush here.
So what we do, paint trees in, wash it across, and then do it again.
And then let it dry.
Yeah.
Mainly.
Yeah.
And then do it again.
Later.
And eventually you'll get, I feel like I might get a depth to it and a mysterious quality, which is what I really want.
Excellent. Excellent.
But I'm not sure this will work.
Well, you don't know until you go, do you?
I mean, it's
I mean, there are elements about that. I mean, not looking at it particularly because you want to copy it, because I would hate to think you would, but there are lights coming through, aren't there? These little, and they're not sort of consistent all the way through. They start here and then they disappear and then they come back again.
Yeah.
Would you exploit any of that sort of feel in it or not? Or do you want it really a sort of blanket mist coming right the way through?
I think I'll do sort of waves of mist.
Where? I think the thing about that is, you see, if you have an idea about it, which you obviously have, and the way you're going to do it, that could change as you go because, it'll suggest things to you in the doing of it. And then sometimes you ignore those things and go with your idea, or other times you sort of think, oh yeah, that's it. Like for instance here, see how that's gone.
I know, that was an accident. I've got to thinking like this.
Yeah, yeah, no, that's good.
Because I like that, and that's why I want it all to be misty like that.
Right.
But as you say, it might evolve differently.
I think in a way it should, you should be allowing it to, let's put it that way. Yeah. Anyway, I look forward to seeing it, that's brilliant. I'll come and see you later.
Yeah, I don't know how far I get.
You'll get far. That'll be okay, that's nice. That's a good idea. Great, okay, I'll see you later. Right. How are you doing?
This is a drawing I'm doing with Tombows, which are watercolour pens.
And they're very bright, aren't they?
Very bright.
Yeah.
So really, it doesn't really bear relation to the photograph which I took when I had a trip to Death Valley in Nevada.
Good, lucky you.
It was
very much more muted than that.
It's greyer, isn't it? I mean, the atmosphere is greyer, but you know,
it is. But I'm making it.
But
quite,
I don't think that matters. Hot, yeah, yeah.
It was a hot day.
Yeah, good. And that's the way you probably felt about it too. That's another thing. You obviously felt fairly up about the whole thing, didn't you?
I did, but I'm not sure about these rocks. If they are.
What are you
right
not sure
colour
about?
Well, I'm trying to make them. If I make them black, then they're just very miserable.
But you can get them darker. You've already got that darker, haven't you? I mean, that's probably as dark. You could get as dark as that, certainly, by mixing maybe that violet colour. Is that straight out of the tube, as it were?
Yes, it's sort of this colour here.
And these are water soluble, aren't they?
Yes, they
so
are.
So you could probably put that on, then find a bit of something a bit darker and work it in with your brush, and you'll get a, you know, a mixture of the two colours, and it'll go darker. I'd also get the sky in fairly soon. I mean, you usually think it's as dark as that?
Not quite sure.
It could be quite bright, because everything else you've got is bright, isn't it?
Well,
I
don't know which sort of bright.
But don't do too much of that until you've done the sky, because you'll need to do those over the top. You can't go around it, really, can you?
No.
And also through there.
Well,
you know,
I didn't do the sky because I'm not really a landscape painter.
Ah, is this the first? Not your first landscape, is it?
Really, it is almost.
Is
really,
it?
It is.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
I've done gardens.
This could be the beginning of something else then, couldn't it?
Gardens I've done, but not really landscape.
Okay. Yeah. But, and also, this one, there's a lot of texture there, isn't there? There's all these little lumps and bumps.
Well, I could do.
Which is nice, because you've got a lot of very simple areas, particularly as you go back.
I could sort of do little
marks. Absolutely, like just like almost like writing, you know, graffiti, you draw it in.
And that'll
work if you get this darker. You know, you could do, the more tone and richness you get here, the more you can get in there, you know, it's...
I'll have a go.
Anyway, it's looking nice, but I'd certainly...
Do the sky now?
Get it in, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Good. Okay.
Thank you.
Good.
Thank you very much.
Could you tell me what it's about?
It is a painting which has been inspired by foliage in different seasons.
This stuff here.
Yeah. Different seasons. So I've got some which are dried leaves and some which are not so of the fall colours.
Yeah, they're green.
Yeah, and I have got a couple of roses which I have dried, which I am going to try and portray in just to show the different seasons again.
Yeah.
And it's more of a surrealistic, contemporary painting.
Yeah, I mean, the reason I asked you is, I mean, it's not about a place, is it? It's an idea about something else much more sort of spiritual in a way, isn't it?
Yes, and it's more of it's more of an atmosphere as well.
Yes.
And I will be bringing in quite a bit of light through the branches of the trees and making this into a lot of shade, more darker tones there.
Strangely enough, it actually looks like a place. You know, it's actually taking on a sort of an image of a particular sort of little area somewhere because of the way the trees are growing up and the way you've got the sky at the top, if it is the sky, and all this stuff here. But it's you've got some lovely sort of effects here. That bit you're just working on there, you know, those sort of really sharp little accents of the leaves echoing this up here. And what are you going to do with that?
I'm going to do that. Going to bring in a bit of sky, a bit of light coming through that, because this is supposed to be all sunshine.
Yeah,
and that's going to be the shadow part of the foliage.
Yeah.
So hopefully, when I finish, this will bring in more of a lot of light through the branches.
And did you do that all that there before? I mean, it's not on top of another picture, is it?
No. This is. Actually, what I've done is I've done that with a cling film, and I have actually drawn that first.
Yes.
I've drawn that with ink, just to give that image first, and then I've used a cling film to get the background, so that's how you get
When you say you used a cling film, what did you do?
I put in very liquid, not too liquid, acrylic, and then put the cling film on it, and then let it dry a bit. And
then take it off and you get it sticky.
But then I get those...
You get those patchy...
Patchy.
Yeah, which you
faces,
can't...
Yes.
I mean, they're totally random, really, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah, and I use a bit of alcohol there. I've got a bit of
alcohol.
Alcohol,
my goodness. Oh.
So I just...
So what does that do?
It does give you sort of a circles where the alcohol falls. It spreads the...
Ah, right,
the
it dissolves it. And it is.
Yeah, it's disposable.
It? Yeah, yeah.
So that's because of that. Yeah. So I've used different ways to get
my... No, it's
my good.
It's like almost a mixed media, isn't it? You've
and
got these thin bits here too, which is nice.
Yeah, so what I did was initially did that with a fine ink pen, and then I... Did a clear gesso on it rather than the other white gesso. So the clear gesso you can see through.
Yeah. So there's a lot going on, isn't it, on the surface? I mean, to achieve what you've achieved so far, you've actually used lots of different ways of doing it, haven't you? With your cling film and your alcohol and all the other stuff. It's sort of layering up almost, isn't it? Which
exactly.
is which is lovely. Yes,
so I'm
it's
not going to. I don't want to lose that effect.
No, you don't.
So try to bring in the highlights.
It's nice also where you've got thin paint, you know, that's quite nice showing through, and then these more solid areas, which is quite good. Lovely, that's really good. I'm very impressed and interested in the fact that you're using this as a source, you know, rather than a place, because it is almost a place, isn't it?
It is.
It's about something that you remember from a place. So.
More about life,
yeah,
really.
Absolutely. Yes, that's lovely. Good, well done. How are we doing? This is your second one of this, isn't it? You did one earlier, which was the same thing, but without snow.
That's the one
you did, yes, right.
That was
so
quick and this is slow.
This is. Why do you think that is? Why is it slow? Is it harder?
Well, partly because I intended it to be, but also because, yes, it is more complex.
Because of the white, presumably, isn't it? Yes, it's sort of... It blocks out all the shapes and forms. So actually it becomes something else, doesn't it? It becomes something about texture and shine and glitter and stuff. What are you going to do about this here? Are you going to keep that fairly thin and watery? Which would be nice.
I imagine
you've already
it being
got
a bit like
that yeah.
But I was waiting to see how it looked when banks.
And is there any chance of the white going up into here?
Oh, it will, because there's blossom. There's
oh yes,
cherry blossom challenge.
Is that cherry blossom?
Yes.
So that's something. So that would be a different colour. That would be pinky slightly, wouldn't it?
I hope
a little
so.
Bit.
Yeah. I certainly need something to make it look different.
Which would be interesting. Yeah, but actually that's interesting because you've got that and that line follows through. There's a sort of rhythm right the way through, isn't there? Going right the way through there, which will be accentuated by the time you get that there, because you'll have that the other side of it. Yes, that's looking...
I probably need some more dark up there.
Yeah, you probably will. And also this tree going up there. But no, it's looking nice. What about this? Because that's a reflection, isn't it, coming into it? That's quite strong, actually.
Yes, it was darker earlier. It's gone light.
Oh, okay. Will you get it darker again?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's looking really good. Super. Lovely. You've done it. When did you start that? Not today.
This is my second session.
Yeah. So that's pretty good. Okay.
Thank you.
Well done. Well, that's amazing. When we came in, you had a blank canvas, nothing on it at all, a few pencil marks, and now it's almost a complete picture. I know you'll go on working on it, because you always do, because you know you take it as far as you can, but that is a very complete picture given the time that you've actually spent on it, which is only a couple of hours, let's face it. So, and it's lovely. I can see all sorts of things which, you know, you could do if you bring it in on Tuesday. We could talk about it. But that's terrific. Well done, Linda. That's really, really good.
Thank you.
Smashing. And it's a very strong composition too. These linear shapes that you've got here, which are great. Do you think it will get any more sort of abstract than that, or?
No, it won't get any more abstract. No. It'll probably get more realistic.
Will it? Yeah, okay.
A bit more. The colours, I don't think I'm not quite happy with the colours there.
What aren't you happy about?
I think it's too warm.
Do Do you? Okay. I quite like that, actually, I have to say.
But it'll fine. Stay.
No, not necessarily, because it works well with the green for a start, which is nice. And you got, what about the wheel? That was a good image, wasn't it? That sort of, is it a wheel or what?
Whatever it is.
Yeah.
Need a bit more definition.
You've got it sort of, you know, reiterated right in the centre there, which is nice. No, that's great. You've done ever so well. Really good.
Thank you.
Well done. Right, I'd like to finish the day by saying thank you very much for coming, all of you. It's been an interesting experience. I think one of the, or several of the advantages of doing a workshop are that, first place, there's usually a theme to a workshop, whether it's the media or whether it's the subject or whatever it is, and it does focus the mind. I know there are people here today who probably haven't done landscape or certainly haven't concentrated on landscape, so it's a fairly sort of, you know, it's difficult for those people, but maybe more exciting, I don't know. But, and the other thing is that you get to see what everybody else is doing, and I know that in this class there's a mix of people who wouldn't normally work together. They might work in other groups, but they don't necessarily work with all the people here. So it's interesting for them, and it's, well, both sides of the coin, really, and it's certainly interesting for me. But and I'd like to congratulate you, really, because on walking around, even to people I haven't talked to, although I have talked to people who aren't involved in what we've been doing, but it's been, I'm amazed at what you've done, actually. There was a painting that was, when we first came in, was a blank canvas. It literally was a blank canvas. And now it's not finished, but there's a lot there. And there are other people who've brought in stuff which they'd started, and they've taken it on quite a lot and listened to what was said and so on. So, you know, in a workshop situation where people are doing all sorts of different things, sometimes it's hard to concentrate. But I think you've done incredibly well. And thank you very much. That's brilliant. I've enjoyed the day.